Shanghai stocks go international. Big mergers in Chinese telecoms. Iron ore, Taiwan, foreign exchange, and the Sichuan earthquake. American businesses may soon be able to list on Shanghai in a stunning change anticipated by Nisei Euronext Inc. CEO Duncan Niederauer and Business Development VP David Schuler are working closely with the China Securities Regulatory Commission on a project to offer shares in the exchange company as a test and example of foreign listings in China. If successful, many American companies could be interested in a Shanghai listing. That could lead to a massive shakeup between the world's big stock exchanges. Something to watch closely. The long-anticipated restructuring of China's telecom giants is underway. China Unicom will buy the shares of China Netcom at a 3% premium over the last share price prior to a halt of trading May 23rd. As combined, the new firm, which will probably use the China Unicom brand, will have a market capitalization around $63 billion and a range of services from mobile phones, fixed line subscribers, and broadband delivery. It will sell its CDMA business to China Telecom. Meanwhile, China Mobile, the world's biggest mobile phone provider, will buy China Tietong, or Railway Telecommunications, the smallest of China's fixed line operators. Part of the restructuring will require use of China's homegrown standard, TDSC-DMA, rolling out but still being refined. There will be much more activity in this sector over the short term with potential for more mergers and share price volatility. According to Zhang Shaogang, head of the China Iron and Steel Association, talks with Australia may conclude with an agreement on prices by end June. Chinese steelmakers, led by giant Baowu Steel, want an annual term contract and are playing Australia against Brazil. Australian producers, such as BHP Billiton, want more than an 80% increase due to freight costs. But earlier, China, along with Japan and South Korea, got Brazil to agree to a price increase of 65% to no more than 71%. Further sign of the growing links between Taiwan and the mainland, Chinese and Taiwan officials are in talks to allow UnionPay, the dominant national ATM network of China, to place ATMs in Taiwan as early as July, when the first wave of Chinese visitors to the island may begin. The UnionPay ATMs would introduce renminbi currency into Taiwan and could someday lead to its acceptance or even circulation on the island. As of the end of April, China's foreign exchange reserves swelled to over $1.75 trillion, by far the largest foreign reserves in the world. As Chinese exports have slowed, the increases are coming largely from investment inflows, and some analysts believe as much as 50 billion hot or speculative money may be circulating in China. 3 weeks in and devastation is still being assessed from the earthquake disaster in Sichuan province. Over 69,000 are confirmed dead, and damages are valued at over $10 billion. Around 5 million people may be homeless. Almost $6 billion in donations has been raised so far, much of it from Chinese donors in a massive national outpouring of sympathy and help. The relief effort is enormous, and Beijing's willingness to allow outsiders and their support into the region is doing more to bring Chinese closer to the world outside than the Summer Olympics could ever hope to. Stay tuned for my trip report on China, Taiwan, and the Eastern Caribbean next. I'll see you next time on the Sinomania Show.